cross. Love so amazing. Love so amazing. Jesus Messiah, name above all names, blessed Redeemer. Rescue for sinners, the ransom from heaven, Jesus Messiah, Lord of all. His body the bread, his blood the wine, broken and poured out all for love. The whole earth trembled and the veil was torn. Love so amazing. Love so amazing. Jesus Messiah, name above. Rescue for sinners, the ransom from heaven, Jesus Messiah, Lord of all. Our hope is in you. Jesus Messiah, name above all names, oh blessed Redeemer, Emmanuel, the rescue for sinners, the ransom for Jesus Messiah, Lord of all. Jesus Messiah, Lord of all.
Good morning, everyone.
Good morning, Father.
Welcome all of you here today to the Feast of the Body and Blood of Christ, also known as Corpus Christi. I'd like to also welcome today our special guests that we have with us, especially Father Brian Welding, who is on my left over here, Father Larry Adams, who's running around somewhere else, Father Tom Miller, Father Faustine Ferrara, he's our special guest from Tanzania, and Deacon Rick Tusik, and Deacon Mike Kelly. And then we have a special deacon here with us for the first time coming to celebrate with us at a Mass, who was ordained yesterday at St. Paul's Cathedral. So now his official title from us can be, if you like to use it, Deacon Frank Bursig. So welcome. So let us continue our celebration in the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
The grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, the love of God the Father, and the communion of the Holy Spirit be with you all.
And with your spirit.
As we prepare ourselves to celebrate the sacred mysteries, let us call to mind our sins.
Lord Jesus, you came to reconcile us to one another and to the Father. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Lord Jesus, you healed the wounds of sin and division. Christ, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Lord Jesus, you intercede for us with your Father. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy. May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life.
Amen.
Glory to God in the highest, and on earth peace to people of goodwill. We praise you, we bless you, we adore you, we glorify you, we give you thanks for your great glory, Lord God, heavenly King, O God, Almighty Father, Lord Jesus Christ, only begotten Son, Lord God, Lamb of God, Son of the Father. Take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. You take away the sins of the world, receive our prayer. You are seated at the right hand of the Father. Have mercy on us.
Let us pray. O God, who in this wonderful sacrament have left us a memorial of your passion, grant us, we pray, so to revere the sacred mysteries of your body and blood, that we may always experience in ourselves the fruits of your redemption, who live and reign with God the Father in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God forever and ever.
Amen.
A reading from the book of Deuteronomy. Moses said to the people, "Remember how for 40 years now the Lord your God has directed all of your journeying in the desert, so as to test you by affliction, and find out whether or not it was your intention to keep his commandments. He therefore let you be afflicted with hunger, and then fed you with manna, a food unknown to you and your fathers, in order to show you that not by bread alone does one live, but by every word that comes forth from the mouth of the Lord. Do not forget the Lord your God, who brought you out of the land of Egypt, that place of slavery, who guided you through the vast and terrible desert with its seraph serpents and scorpions, its parched and waterless ground, who brought forth water for you from the flinty rock and fed you in the desert with manna, a food unknown to your fathers. The word of the Lord.
Praise the Lord, Jerusalem. Praise the Lord, Jerusalem. Praise the Lord, Jerusalem. Praise the Lord, Jerusalem. Glorify the Lord, O Jerusalem. Praise your God, O Zion. Strengthen the bars of your gates. He has blessed your children within you. Praise the Lord, Jerusalem. Praise the Lord, Jerusalem. He has granted peace in your borders. With the best of wheat, he fills you. Sends forth his command to the earth, swiftly runs his word. Praise the Lord, Jerusalem. Praise the Lord, Jerusalem.
A reading from the first letter of St. Paul to the Corinthians. Brothers and sisters, the cup of blessing that we bless, is it not a participation in the blood of Christ? The bread that we break, is it not a participation in the body of Christ? Because the loaf of bread is one, we, though many, are one body, for we all partake of the one loaf. The word of the Lord.
Alle, alle, alleluia. Alle, alle, alleluia. Alle, alle, alleluia. Alleluia. Alle, alle, alleluia. Alle, alle, alleluia. Alle, alle, alleluia. Alleluia.
I am the living bread that came down from heaven. This bread will live forever.
Alle, alle, alleluia. Alle, alle, alleluia. Alle, alle, alleluia. Alleluia. Alle, alle, alleluia. Alle, alle, alleluia. Alleluia, alleluia.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
A reading from the Holy Gospel according to John. Jesus said to the Jewish crowd, I am the living bread that came down from heaven. Whoever eats this bread will live forever. And the bread that I will give is my flesh for the life of the world. The Jews quarreled amongst themselves, saying, "How can this man give us flesh to eat?" Jesus said to them, "Amen, amen, I say to you, unless you eat the flesh of the Son of Man and drink his blood, you do not have life within you. Whoever eats my flesh and drinks my blood has eternal life, and I will raise him on the last day. For my flesh is true food, and my blood is true drink. Whoever eats my flesh and drinks my blood remains in me, and I in him. Just as the living Father sent me, I have become life because of the Father. So also the one who feeds on me will have life because of me. This is the bread that came down from heaven. Unless your ancestors who ate and still died, whoever eats this bread will live forever." The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
Well, let me start off by saying that I didn't realize that becoming a deacon was a dangerous job. I can't tell you how many death threats I've been having since I now can do a homily. But for all those who want to start the watch, don't start yet, because give me a little time and indulge me for a moment while I offer thanks, because there's so many people that I have been blessed to have met along my journey and have helped me. I'd like to start first with Father Al, not only for being a director and a sponsor for me throughout the last 18 months since his arrival, but also because he's allowed me to deliver this first homily as part of our parish family here. I'd also like to thank all the priests and deacons with us here today. They're very special people in my life. Father Al, Father Tom, Father Larry, Father Rick, Deacon Mike, and Deacon Rick. They're here to celebrate with me today, and I thank you so much. I also have a special guest here that's so dear in my heart, and that is Father Brian Welding. Father Brian Welding has been my spiritual director for 5 years. He has truly inspired me with his love of the Lord and truly assisted me in my spiritual development. I also want to offer a special thanks to Deacon Mike, because he has been the mast of my ship. Having gone through this before, he has provided me with the strength over the past 6 years and has never left my side as I journeyed in my formation. All these holy men have been just an inspiration to me over this time. But I would be remiss if I didn't recognize Karen, the love of my life, and her constant support, which she has provided me, her love and constant listening ear. The words of wisdom when needed help me through the best of times and even the darkest moments of doubt. I also want to recognize my family, my daughters Juliana, Samantha, and Hannah, and my son-in-laws Mark and Anthony. Your love and your encouragement and your prayers have helped me in such immeasurable ways that you may never know. I love you all, and I look forward to our continued journey together. Finally, but last but not least, I want to thank you, my parish family, all those that have provided the love and support and the prayers that have helped me to continue to hear my call, and I hope that we will continue to be close, and I know that I will be with you, and I hope that I will be able to assist you in both good times and bad. I promise you I will love you to the graces of God bestows on me in the years to come. Thank you, each and every one of you, for everything you've done for me, especially over the last 6 years. It is so great today to see the many families gathered here, both in the church as well as live stream. For the first time in as many months, and truly celebrate this beautiful occasion of the solemnity of the body and blood of Christ. We are back together as a family, praising with one voice. How exciting is this that we're opening our churches back up? If you aren't excited, you better have someone check your pulse. let us now just take, before we start to celebrate, just let's take a moment and kind of give all of our distractions, all the troubles, anxieties, everything that we've experienced over the last couple of months to the Lord and say we're giving it up because we're back together and truly enjoy this time with Him and with each other. Get ready, because today we celebrate something that is central to our faith, Christ truly in the Eucharist. The year was 1263. A priest from Prague was making a pilgrimage to Rome, asking God for help to strengthen his faith since he was having doubt about his vocation. Along the way, he stopped outside of Rome. While celebrating Mass there, he raised the host during the consecration, and the bread turned into flesh and began to bleed. The drops of blood fell onto the small white cloth on the altar called the corporal. This was an amazing event, and it so inspired Pope Urban IV the following year to institute the feast we celebrate today, the Body and Blood of Christ. And if you're interested, you can actually see the bloodstained corporal in the Basilica of Oviedo in north of Rome. But some might say, Deacon Frank, that kind of sounds strange for me still. I'm getting used to that. How can this be? You don't see any change in the bread and wine. There's no difference in taste. The bread still tastes like bread. The wine still tastes like wine. It's going against logic to say that bread and wine changes into the body and blood of Jesus, despite no change in appearance. I know that some find it difficult to believe that bread and wine change into the body and blood of Jesus, and I can certainly understand our doubts. So let me provide a more compelling miracle story of the Eucharist. There was a Eucharistic miracle that happened in the year 700. A monk who feared he was losing his vocation was celebrating Mass. And during the consecration, the host turned into flesh and the wine turned into blood. Despite the fact that the miracle took place over 1,300 years ago, you can still go see the flesh in a monstrance which is exposed every day, and the blood in a glass chalice. The blood is congealed and is now in 5 clots in the glass chalice. So, of course, in our world of skepticism today, we had to have the Doubting Thomases. So in 1971 and again in 1978, a hospital laboratory actually tested the blood and the flesh. And they discovered the flesh is mitochondrium. If you don't know what that is, that's heart muscle tissue. So we can say it is actually the heart of Jesus, the Sacred Heart. And actually, when they tested the blood, they found that it was type AB. And what's really neat about that is that when NASA scientists tested the Shroud of Turin, it actually found that the blood on the shroud was actually type AB. So despite the fact that we actually see that the flesh and blood still remains preserved over this time, they also discovered that there was no preservatives in this blood. But here's what I find most amazing. I told you there are 5 clots. If you weigh 1 clot, it weighs a certain amount. If you weigh all 5 clots, they all weigh the same amount together. If you weigh 2, it's the same number. Every combination of the 5 clots that you can put together and weigh, you find that the weight is exactly the same. So doesn't this show you that the full Jesus is present in even the particles of the Eucharist, no matter how small? This is why we take such precious care of that precious body and blood. This is why we worry about every particle when we purify our vessels or if we would drop the host on the ground. Because Jesus is in every part. Because this is such an incredible thing if you think about it. But then again, you know that Jesus said, this flesh is true food and this blood is true drink. But are we really serious about this whole thing about it becoming the body and blood as opposed to a symbol? If you go back in time to when the actual original language was in Greek, you'll find that what Jesus said did not just say, take this bread and eat it. He used a much stronger word. And in Greek, he used something like, eat my flesh, but chew on my flesh. gnaw on my flesh, crunch the flesh in my teeth. The original language, when we talked about them receiving the manna, we talk about Jesus saying that they ate the bread from heaven and died. But in this case, he leaves no room for doubt that this is truly his flesh and that we should consume it because it's the real presence of Christ. But if you have a problem with any of the things I just said, in this modern world that we live in, go ahead and Google Eucharistic miracles, and you'll find there are so many out there that hopefully will convince you of this. But you know, it's kind of interesting because we're all about the idea of intellect, right? So we think about the logic and we think about how does this happen. And the bottom line is, Paul said so beautifully, in the Christian life, we go by faith and not by sight. So when we put all this reason and intellect together, we realize that we also have to have faith. And we have to realize that every day in this churches around the world, the miracle of the Eucharist happens. So the question has to be, can you add faith to your intellect? Can you believe during the consecration by the priest that he actually turns the bread and wine into the body and blood of Christ? And just one more clarifying thing that we're always misconceiving in people outside is that Jesus gave up his body for us on Calvary. And he gives up his body for you and me at every Mass so that we may receive him in communion. But it's one sacrifice on Calvary, extended through time to each Mass that we celebrate. No, it's not the sacrifice of Jesus on Calvary only, but it's the extension of that sacrifice through time to us in every Mass. And Jesus wants to have us enjoy the intimate relationship with him when he especially said, "Whoever eats my flesh and drinks my blood remains in me and I in him." So therefore, communion, Holy Communion, is the essence and center of our life. To have faith in the revelation that we can and must receive the body and blood dramatically reconfigures our lives in every detail. On this feast of the body and blood of Christ, make it your prayer that you will accept God's graces to make an act of Eucharistic faith that is greater than ever before and most pleasing to God. All of us together form the church, one church, and Jesus is the center of it, and most present in the Blessed Sacrament. Today's celebration of the body and blood of Christ is the feast of the very center and heart of our church, our faith, our parish, and the center and heart of the lives of each of us, Jesus and the Blessed Sacrament. So even though, as you may have heard, I may be venturing over across the way to Holy Family Church, parish, as I begin my ministry, we will be celebrating and praising our one true God together each week, each day, as we do with the whole universal church. So today, my challenge to each of you, as we gather around this table, get excited. Get excited about your faith and allow God to fill you with the Holy Spirit so that you are ready to explode with his love and joy in your heart. Turn your life completely over to his divine providence, and he will lead you to a joy that is unfathomable. Also, let us be thankful to Jesus for giving himself for our salvation, and let him faithfully believe and honor him as true God in our Eucharistic feast, as we come forward to consume the real body and blood of Christ, knowing it is truly Jesus and not a symbol. Let us come to his table praising him and affording him the utmost respect. And let us consume Jesus in the Eucharist today, both physically here, spiritually online, and to show everyone that we meet that we not only know Jesus Christ, but we share an intimate relationship with him and have a radical love for him.
Now let us profess our faith. I believe in one God, the Father Almighty, maker of heaven and earth, of all things visible and invisible. I believe in one Lord Jesus Christ, the only begotten Son of God, born of the Father before all ages, God from God, light from light, true God from true God, begotten, not made, consubstantial with the Father. Through him all things were made. For us men and for our salvation, he came down from heaven,
but the Holy Spirit
was incarnate of the Virgin Mary,
and became man.
For our sake,
crucified,
suffered death, rose again on the third day, in accordance with the Scriptures. He ascended into heaven, and is seated at the right hand of the Father. He will come again in glory to judge the living and the dead, and his kingdom will have no end. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Lord, the giver of life, who proceeds from the Father and Son, who with the Father and Son is adored and glorified, who has spoken through the prophets. I believe in one holy Catholic and Apostolic Church, confess one baptism against the sins, and I look forward to the resurrection and life for the world to come. With hope and love and thanks for everything we have, let us now bring our petitions to our Heavenly Father.
Please respond, Lord, hear our prayer. For Pope Francis, our bishop, priests, and all who serve the Church, may the Lord strengthen them in their mission of bringing the light of Christ to a weary world. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For our civic leaders and all who help formulate public policy, may the Holy Spirit guide them in all that they do. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For people in war-torn countries, may God bring them peace and security. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For this gathered assembly, may the love and truth that God has poured into our hearts sustain us in all that we do. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For all who have completed their pilgrimage on earth, may they find eternal joy in the heavenly home. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For the parishioners of Christ the Divine Shepherd Parish for whom this Mass is offered, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
And for any specials we hold in the silence of our hearts, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer. Father, we thank you for bringing all the people here today. We thank you for helping us to celebrate with Frank the joy that he has received. And we ask you to always watch over us, give us hope, give us strength, give us love. And let us go forth as we do today and every day to bring you and your Son and the body and blood to others by the way we act and the way we treat one another. We ask all of this through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
We all start on the outside looking in. This is where grace begins. We were hungry, we were thirsty, with nothing left to give. Oh, the shape that we were in. And just when all hope seemed lost, love opened the door for us. He said, come to the table. Come join the sinners. You have been redeemed. Take your place beside the Savior. Sit down and be set free. Come to the table. Come meet
motley crew of misfits, these liars and these thieves. There's no one unwelcome here. And that sin and shame that you brought with you, you can leave it at the door and let mercy draw you near. So come to the table. Come join the sinners. You have been redeemed. Take your place beside the Savior. Sit down and be set free. Come to the table. Come to the table.
Pray, my friends, that this sacrifice may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father.
May the Lord accept the sacrifice at your hands for the praise and the glory of his name, for our good and of all his household.
Grant your church, O Lord, we pray, the gifts of unity and peace, whose signs are to be seen in mystery in the offerings we here present through Christ our Lord.
Amen. Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God, through Christ our Lord. For at the Last Supper with his apostles, establishing for the ages to come the saving memories of the cross, he offered himself to you as the unblemished lamb, the acceptable gift of perfect praise. Nourishing your faithful by this sacred mystery, you make them holy so that the human race, bounded by one world, may be enlightened by one faith and united in one bond of charity. And so we approach the table of his wondrous sacrament, so that, bathed in the sweetness of your grace, we may pass over to the heavenly realities here foreshadowed. Therefore, all creatures of heaven and earth sing a new song in adoration, and we, with all the hosts of angels, cry out and without end acclaim. Created rightly gives you praise, for through your Son, our Lord Jesus Christ, by the power and working of the Holy Spirit, you give life to all things and make them holy, and you never cease to gather a people to yourself. so that from the rising of the sun to its setting, a pure sacrifice may be offered to your name. Therefore, O Lord, we humbly implore you by the same Spirit, graciously make holy these gifts we have brought to you for consecration, so that they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ, at whose command we celebrate these mysteries. For on the night he was betrayed, he himself took bread, and giving you thanks, he said the blessing, broke the bread, and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and giving you thanks, he said the blessing, and gave the chalice to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." The mystery of faith.
We proclaim your death, O Lord, and profess your resurrection until you come again.
Therefore, Lord, as we celebrate the memorial of the saving passion of your Son, his wondrous resurrection and ascension into heaven, and as we look forward to his second coming, we offer you in thanksgiving this holy and living sacrifice. Look, we pray, upon the oblation of your church, and recognizing the sacrificial victim by whose death you will to reconcile us to yourself, grant that we who are nourished by the body and blood of your Son and filled with his Holy Spirit may become one body, one spirit in Christ. May he make of us an eternal offering to you, so that we may obtain an inheritance with your elect, especially with the most blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with blessed Joseph, her spouse, with the blessed apostles and holy saints, on whose constant intercession in your presence we rely for unfailing help. May this sacrifice of our reconciliation, we pray, O Lord, advance the peace and salvation of all the world. Be pleased to confirm in faith and charity your pilgrim church on earth, with your servant Francis, our Pope, and David, our Bishop, the order of bishops, all the clergy and the entire people you have gained for your own. Listen graciously to the prayers of this family whom you have summoned before you. In your compassion, O merciful Father, gather to yourself all your children scattered throughout the world. To our departed brothers and sisters, and to all who were pleasing to you at their passing from this life, give kind admittance to your kingdom. There we hope to enjoy forever the fullness of your glory, through Christ our Lord, through whom you bestow on this world all that is good.
Through him and with him and in him, O God, almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever.
Confidence to the Father in the words our Savior gave us.
Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed.
Lord, we pray, from every evil, graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy, we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ.
For the kingdom and the power and the glory are yours, now and forever.
Lord Jesus Christ, you said to your apostles, "Peace I leave you, my peace I give you." Look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
The peace of the Lord be with you always.
And with your spirit.
Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world. Have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world. Have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of
on this feast of the body and blood of Christ, behold the Lamb of God, behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb.
Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word, and my soul shall be healed.
Since those watching are unable to share in the physical reception of the Eucharist today, let us join in praying an act of spiritual communion together. My Jesus, I believe that you are present in the most holy sacrament. I love you above all things, and I desire to receive you into my soul. Since I cannot at this moment receive you sacramentally, come at least spiritually into my heart. I embrace you as if you were already there, and unite myself wholly to you. Never permit me to be separated from you. Amen.
Miracle of grace, mystery of faith. calling us to venture to the deep. Though our senses fail, your graces still prevail, and we become the love that we receive. Bread of life, bread of life. Those who eat this bread shall live and never die. In this holy sacrifice, bread of
Let us pray. Grant, O Lord, we pray that we may delight for all eternity in that share in your divine life which is foreshadowed in the present age by our reception of your precious body and blood, who live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
Today, after our Mass, we will have communion in the parking lot at 11 o'clock, both at St. Susanna as well as here at St. Bernadette. And so we'll have a very short service at that time, and then you will receive it. Also, once again, thanks to our deacon for being with us, all deacons, but especially one special deacon is glowing. So thank him.
Thank you.
Beautiful new garments. So. And also, we want to say the prayer of St. Michael the Archangel. St. Michael the Archangel, defend us in battle. Be your
defense against the wickedness and snares of the devil. May God rebuke him, we humbly pray. And do thou, O righteous
companions,
for thou art our God,
cast in all evil spirits, cry out the world, seeking the most. The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Bow down for the blessing.
Be near to those who call on you, O Lord, and graciously grant your protection to all who place their hope in your mercy, that they may remain faithful in holiness of life, and having enough of their deeds in this world, they may be made full heirs of your promise for eternity through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
And may Almighty God bless you all, Father, Son, and Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Go in peace.
Thanks be to God. I don't hear saying that.
Who am I that the highest king would welcome me? I was lost, but he brought me in. Oh, his love for me. Oh, his love. Has ransomed me, his grace runs deep. While I was a slave to sin, Jesus died for me. Yes, he died for me. The Son sets free. Oh, is free indeed. I'm a child of God. Yes, I.